rejoice that there are owls. Let them do idiotic and maniacal hooting for men. It is a sound admirably suited to swamps and undeveloped nature, which men have not recognized. All day the sun has shone on the surface of some savage swamp, and the single spruce stands hung with usnea lichens, small hawks circulate above, the chickadee lisps among the evergreens, the partridge and rabbit skulk beneath. But now a more dismal and fitting day dawns, and a different race of creatures awakens to express the meaning of nature there. Perhaps I am more than usually jealous with respect to my freedom. I feel that my connection with and obligations to society are still very slight and transient. Those slight labors which afford me a livelihood, and by which it is allowed that I am to some extent serviceable to my contemporaries, are yet as commonly a pleasure to me, and I am not often reminded that they are a necessity. I saw Walt Whitman at market yesterday. We made eye contact, but he didn't smile. Is he mad at me? I was at Macy's today. They had the most darling pumps I've ever seen. They fit me like a glove. A footed glove. But $180 for shoes? Forget about it. But I will miss those shoes. Should have bought them. Shoes like that don't come around often. They're darling.
When your world is full of strange arrangements and gravity won't pull you through, you know you're missing out on something. Well, that something depends on you.